Welcome back, everyone. In this episode, we're going to start applying the Aztec decaling. Okay, everyone, now, before I can actually start putting the Aztec deckling on, I used my felt marker. This is a 0.5, and I just filled in all the other windows that I did not cut out. So you can see the results there. And I did the same for underneath and the rest of the ship here as well. Just so it looks a whole lot better. Now I have to put a dull coat on everything to seal it all in, because it's going to be a lot of water use. If you put water on this now, all this black, it'll run. So I have to seal it in before I can even start on the Aztec deckling. Okay, so we got everything here. This is the ones that I ordered online. These decals here came with the model. One of my other models. So I'm going to start with this section here, which goes here. It's really large, so I'm gonna have to put it in sections, so I was gonna cut it in half just so it's easier to apply it. So I got all the instructions here where each one of these Aztec deckling goes. Obviously for areas like in here, I have to modify it, especially up in here, which is to be modified. It'll be a little bit difficult, but not impossible. And for the tops of the warp nacelles will have to be modified as well. And these sections in here. And those sections. Basically, almost every area on the engineering hull has to be modified. And of course, on the primary hull as well. Alright, ready to go with the first one here. Just got to water it down and apply it. Alright, so let's see here. Make sure it's thoroughly wet. I'm doing the easiest part first. Dampen down your fingers. Oh, this isn't going to be too bad. Alright. Yep. I knew that was going to happen. Sometimes the edges tend to want to flip over. As it's coming off, it tends to want to wrap around. So you just got to be gentle, move it back so it's flat, get it as flat as you can, and then slowly slide it off. If it's not moving, really wet it down. I mean, get a lot of water on there. You'd want to try and avoid tearing it as much as you can. So if you feel it's too hard to move, I mean, just plow it full of water. Just drown it. And if you've done your job well enough, there's no water that's going to get inside the model, so it should be fine. Okay. Try to line it up as best as I can. Try to get it the way it's supposed to be. Squeeze out gently the excess water. Just use like a regular Kleenex. That, and then just very gently up and down. Don't go like that, because the wetter it gets, it's going to start sticking and it'll pull it along. And once you got like the top part dried off, get the one that's completely dry. Then you can gently very gently, do not push. There you go, that's the start. Looks really good. Woohoo! Another thing, if you put it on and it looks really wrinkly and you got it as smooth as you can, don't worry about it. Once it dries, the wrinkles will go away. Sections here on these two sets of that stuff just to fit that in, and I had to cut along the edges here for these two on the side to fit in there, and it looked not too shabby. Coming along. Alright, now I'm just going to be doing the bottom parts of the warp nacelles on all three engines. That's where the second set of sheets come in for the third warp engine. Okay, there we go. All done there. Get that all done. Bottom half is now complete. Just gotta do the finish off the top of the ship. And this section is complete. Now this here is for the top of the warp engine up here. So it's going to start about here and go back. But because of this, I have to cut out the majority of the center part here. And the center part I'll put on up here after. So... this part here will be on the very back over here. So that's got to be cut off separate. And some of this part here will go on top. And the rest of it will be for something else. Okay, now this thing is pretty much all done now. So I got, looks good. All that done there. Once I put the dull coat on, the shininess of all the decals will disappear. Now I had to modify here on both sides. You see here, there were two full sheets here. So I had to cut that off there, cut that off there, and for the bottom portions, like small little sections here which fit here on both sides there, and for the very back here I just had like a small sliver of a decal going here, which is 164 here. I just had like one small sliver of it go in there and on that side. Okay, so let's see what I'll do. Everything's pretty much all done now. Okay, so for these areas here, I've been cannibalizing the designs from this set here, the ones that came with my other model. So that's where I've been getting those designs from, and I've just been cutting them to fit the areas on both sides. And that there, and yeah, so yeah, it's I'd say it's pretty much done. Alright, so that's it for this episode. In the next episode, we're going to be working on the deckling, the Aztec deckling for the primary hull. So I hope you enjoyed this. Please like, subscribe, and comment. And if you have any questions, or you want me to do some commission work for you, you can contact me at modelbuilder501@yahoo.ca. Thanks again for watching. See you next time.